Hi guys, this is the Photosynthesis prelab video. Today I'm going to show you how to do the floating disc procedure using spinach and baking soda. And so hopefully you have your procedures handy. And I'll be just going through kind of the intricacies of this. This is kind of a tricky lab to set up if you don't know what you're doing. So the first thing you do is you prepare your bicarbonate solution. And so bicarbonate is just baking soda, and as we go through this lab, we're trying to measure photosynthesis, and photosynthesis takes CO2 and turns it into oxygen. Well, in order to measure photosynthesis, we're going to need to give our spinach leaves a source of carbon dioxide, and the source is going to be baking soda. So the first thing you need to do is prepare a solution that has carbon dioxide in it, and so that's going to be 0.2% of this bicarbonate solution. And so it says in your procedures to prepare 900 milliliters of it. I actually think it's easier to do it in 450 milliliter increments, and so you'll have a 500 milliliter Erlenmeyer flask, and so just do it in two separate sets. And just so remember, when you're preparing a 0.2% solution, that it's by mass, so you're going to figure out, well, what's 0.2% of 450 milliliters per se, and then that's how much you're going to measure out on the balance in grams, and then you add water to get up to that 450 milliliters. For the purposes of this lab, it doesn't matter if you use DI water, so we're going to go ahead and use the tap water just because it's easier. You're going to label six of your cups with CO2. And then your seventh cup is going to be without CO2. Without CO2, of course, is your control, because these guys should not be photosynthesizing at all because there's no carbon dioxide. Okay, so with your CO2, I've put my carbonated water in here. It doesn't look carbonated. Usually when we think about carbonated, we think about carbonated gas or the gas CO2 that's in our sodas and whatever, and so in this case we don't want gas in here because we're using gas to indicate to us photosynthesis. So you put your carbonated water in here, and then you're going to add a drop, and I'll get a beaker with a pipetter, but you're going to add a drop of very dilute Dawn soap, and so just one or two drops will do. Okay, and you're trying to avoid bubbles. You don't want bubbles because bubbles are bad. And so once you've got your cups made, you will have spinach leaves, and you're going to hole punch discs in your spinach leaves just like you did with the enzyme lab. And then you're ready to load up 10 of them into your syringe. Forceps are easier. I already punched out all my discs. They're sitting on my piece of paper. There they are. And so I'm going to just use my forceps to put them in my my syringe, and I'm going to put them on the side because if they get stuck in the bottom, then that's troubling or it'll create life more difficult later on. So in they go. They sometimes stick, and our goal with this next step is to get all of the gases out of these discs. And when they're just sitting in the fridge, well, they're still undergoing photosynthesis as long as there's light present. So there's gases in there. There's oxygen and there's CO2 that's in there because they're doing their thing. They're doing photosynthesis. So the hardest part of this lab is actually this next step, vacuuming the gases out of your discs. So I'm putting the plunger in very gently because I need these things to photosynthesize. So I need them to stay alive. And then I'm going to take some of my CO2 water, that's what I have in here, and I'm going to suck it up into my syringe. And this takes a little bit of practice. So I've pulled up as much of my CO2 water as I can, and then I'm going to get the air out. And then I'm going to need more of this CO2 water here in just a second. All right, I got all my air out, or most of my air out. More water. You want to have about half full. You want it to be about like that. Now you'll notice that in this case the discs are floating. They're floating up at the top. And the reason they're floating up at the top is because, like I was saying earlier, they have the gases in there. And so your goal is to get all the gases out of the mesophyll layer of your leaf cells, and instead replace that with your CO2 water. Use this little blue thing. This little blue thing is the cap, and it will prevent you from hurting yourself. So you put the little cap on the top, and then you put your finger on top of it so that you don't accidentally shoot it at your neighbor. and you pull down on the bottom plunger and you're trying to create a vacuum. And you'll actually feel it sucking in, and these guys are going to leak a little bit. But you pull down on this bottom and you're going to see as I do this that we're literally pulling the air out of those discs, out of those spinach discs. And you shake it because you need to agitate it a little bit. You can see all those little bubbles that are literally coming out of the spinach discs as they're exposed to this vacuum. So you pull down and you shake. And what you're going to notice is they actually start rising to the surface more slowly. Okay. So after you shake a few times, release the plunger. And then I'm going to take the top off, and you're like, nothing's changed. It's okay. It's going to take a couple tries. And then I'm going to push very gently on my plunger and get the air out. And we're going to do it again. And I might have actually been pretty successful that first go. My goal is to actually get the discs to sink. And you can see that most of my discs have sunk. I've got one more up at the top. Sometimes if you give them a couple of taps, they'll just fall. Let's see if I'm done. And turns out I'm finished. Usually that's not normal. Normally it takes two or three tries to get the discs to sink. If you have to go into a fourth attempt, you're usually doing way too much damage to the discs, and then they won't photosynthesize when you put them back in their cup here in just a second. So with that in mind, I've been successful. I've gotten all 10 of my discs to sink, and I'm ready to actually test the rate of photosynthesis. And so I'm now ready to pour this back into my, that says without CO2, where's my with CO2? Into my with CO2 cup, and then expose it to the light that I want to test. Now you want to do this pretty quickly, because as long as these guys are exposed to light, they are indeed photosynthesizing. And so at this moment, what they're doing is taking the CO2 and turning it into oxygen gas. Well, the oxygen gas, just like with the enzyme discs, the oxygen gas is going to cause the discs to float. So we can measure the rate of reaction, the rate of photosynthesis in this case, by seeing how long it takes these discs to float. Now, the reason with the enzymes, each test was one disc, and now we're doing 10 discs at a test, is because this process of vacuuming is actually damaging the cells. It's not a normal thing for a spinach leaf to undergo this kind of pressure, and so we know that some of these are being damaged in this process. So what we do is we put 10 discs in here, we dump them all back in the cup. All 10 of those discs together are one trial. And what we measure is how long does it take for half of those discs to reach the surface of our fluid. So in order to get them back in my cup, I take off my blue cap, I pull down on my plunger, they go back in my cup. You can see when I do that, sure enough, they all go down to the bottom, just like I expected. And now I'm going to put my cup into my light box over here. And I'm going to move the camera here in just a second, and I hope it doesn't make you seasick, because, well, there's not much I can do about it. All right, so we're going to come over here, and you can see this is the one I just put in here with CO2. My discs are sunk. And then before I started videoing, I did one more, and you can see here that the discs have all risen. And in this case, we did ultimately get all 10 of them to rise. But what I do is I sit here and I measure from the moment that I get those 10 discs in the cup to the moment that 5 of my 10 are floating, then that is the time measurement I have for that cup. And so in this lab, you guys are going to be measuring the rate of photosynthesis based on two different distances from a light source. And so we'll have two different lamps set up in the classroom so that you can compare those two different sources. If you have a cup that has no floating discs after 20 minutes, we call that no reaction. That's how long we're going to give it. We're going to give it 20 minutes to do this. If it's nice outside and you want to compare one of our inside lamps to outside, the outside sun, you're welcome to do that. I don't care. Same procedure exactly. So you're going to go outside and put it on the concrete and see what we get. But that's it. So that's how we set up this lab. Thanks for watching my video. I was hoping one of these little discs would start floating while I'm videoing, but it doesn't look like they're going to. Come on, buddies. They're working on it. Doesn't take real long. I would say with this one, it was taking, with this cup over here, it took about 5 minutes before they were all floating. So it goes pretty quick. So have a good day. I'll see you in lab. Thanks for watching.